Alright, yo, you know it's your boy Only John Mez. I'm live at Sloppy Vinyl Studios with Who in the Stew. I'm from South Jersey, Clay Rider. Right? Only
let's take things to another level.
Fuck that other lame, he an asshole. He want me in love. I just wanna get to the back though. No, I don't love you, but I fell in love with the cash flow.
Yes, sir.
You know, the vibes be in Jersey with it. And my artist right here.
Oh, we got the King of Clay Rack right here.
Oh, you know I like saying, the sound of that shit. You know the King of Clay Rack.
You know what I'm saying? Shout your name out, man.
I go by the name of Only John Mez. Only John Mez.
Big energy.
And watch your mouth, too. Don't be cursing around your parents.
What made you come with Only John Mez instead of just John Mez?
Okay, I'm always by myself. Uh-huh. But I'm always around a lot of people. So, like, I'm always moving around by myself. So, mm-hmm. That's why I'm only. And, like, the jaw is, like, God. And, like, the Mez is, like, some nomadic shit.
Like, I thought you was on some X-rated shit, like OnlyFans, but Only John
Mez. So, way before OnlyFans, bro. You know what's crazy? I had OnlyFans way before OnlyFans.
Right.
That's a whole bar, money. Yeah. That's a bar.
Yeah, you gotta give me some money to put that in the line.
I got you, bro. Got you.
You from out here? From Clifton?
Hell no.
Oh,
I'm from Clayton. I'm from South Jersey. North Jersey, I moved to North Jersey like 3 years ago.
Three years ago?
Yeah.
What part of South Jersey?
Clayton.
I really want to know how you started making music, because you're not making music like where I'm from.
Yeah.
You making that rock star type shit. Yeah. You got that rock star.
When I listen to you, it reminds me of like Playboy Cardi a little bit.
Word?
You know,
word.
We have that type of vibe.
Yeah, I fuck with Cardi. I don't be giving a fuck when I make music. Like, it was crazy. I started making music because I was like finessing. Mm-hmm. Like, what it was, like, for Christmas, I had got a green screen.
Yeah.
And, like, I was like 15, whatever grade you in when you're 15. And I was doing Photoshop. I was really like nerdy, techie kind of dude. Yeah. And then I made an album cover and started chopping that shit out. I was just selling. I was like, am I shit dropping next month?
Yeah.
And then when next month came, I was like, damn, I gotta drop some shit.
That's when you're 15.
Yeah. So wow. a couple nights before my release date, I had got a PlayStation I. And plugged it into my computer, hooked it up to Logic, and I just went. It was some old shit, like on Dat Piff, they used to have these beat instrumental tapes.
Okay.
And I just started freestyling bullshit.
Yeah, 15, how old you now?
Nope. 22.
22, so 7 years strong.
Yeah, right. 7 years strong. Fucking bitches getting money, dropping songs.
You talk about that a lot in your music.
Yeah, but I'm a sex guy, bro.
Fucking bitches growing, all that. You said all that.
All that. I wear condoms sometimes.
Clearly, he lives in music. Yeah. The funny thing about this is you say the popular introvert.
Yeah.
But, and your name is, you know, Only Jamel, but you kind of Jamel. A lot. Jamel is, sorry. Yeah. Only Jamel is a Jamel, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's all
I said, but you're kind of an energetic guy. You're very lively on IG, you know, lively in person right now. So, you know, introvert guys usually a little bit quieter, hide. You know, explain that.
It's funny, right? Because a lot of people, like, if you know me, you know I have, like, different sides of me. So, like one of my defense mechanisms is the energy. So, like, I'd rather be on stage in front of 1,000 people than be in a room in front of 3 people.
Yeah.
Or I'd rather be in front of a camera, because I know when the camera's mad, motherfuckers behind there, so mm-hmm. I can just turn up. But, like, in my day-to-day life, I just really, I want to help people out and, like, you know, change the world, but I just be on my shit.
Yeah.
I just be on my shit. It's like, I wake up, and you don't know what you're going to get. I'm just
Speaking of helping people out, what's up, that PS5, you gave that up?
That was Spider Cousin's PS5.
Oh, I see y'all both doing that together. Yeah,
I know, bro. You let me stand on it, but it was like, bro, I've been trying to get a PS5. I even tried to slide him some money, low key. Like, I was like, bro, come on. Okay. He's like, we can take a picture, but you the rifles. I'm like, all right, is this awesome?
You know what I'm saying? Nah, since you brought it up, man, I see you outside with Spider Cousin.
I fuck with Spider-Cuz, bro. Spider-Cuz got energy, bro. Spider-Cuz got more energy than me, bro. He crazy. He's Spider-Cuz, my nigga. Nah, I fuck with Spider-Cuz heavy, bro. I fuck with what he's doing. He came here, we made this song.
Wait, hold on. Before that, how y'all even connected? Like,
Spider, my man Rich over there, bro.
Who's Spider, Rich?
Huh?
Who's Rich?
Rich Z. It's Rich Z. That nigga, he like that. He like one of them. Bro, it's Rich Z, my nigga. Like, come on, bro. He like, he's a celebrity, bro. Rich is just like, just think of a football playing, basketball playing, golf, fucking super. That's Rich, my nigga.
Jack, I ain't gonna try Rich. Big shout out to Rich though, 100%. I mean, he front like he not here, but there you go.
Now I'm trying not to look at him while I'm talking about it.
Yeah, show face real quick. Real quick.
Oh, my man, right here. You can see me.
Yeah, you see it. You see the little piece of you here. But shout out Rich. He's probably the reason why we here. And I think I don't know. We found you. We found us.
Nah, I think I found y'all when y'all did the Flock interview.
Got you.
Yeah, and I hit you up and I was like, yo, y'all shit really dope.
And he showed love from, and I love that genuine shit. I don't really. Force no type of energy, so okay. Much respect to him.
Yeah, Rich is a vibe, yeah, bro.
Definitely.
And he's organic too. Not that many people that do what Rich do be like cool.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And he's running Jersey too.
Yeah.
I can see that. But we ain't gonna talk too much about him, not about him.
Yeah, fuck you, Rich.
It's about you and the studio. You know what I'm saying? Explain the studio. Where we at? Where we located?
Are we in Sloppy Vinyl Studios? It's Sloppy Vinyl.
Fire.
What made y'all come up with Sloppy?
Sloppy, because all these niggas out here be neat. For what, my nigga? For what? Neat niggas be lying, bro. Sloppy, bro.
So you got a lot of supporters, though. I see everybody here. You got A&R. Yeah. What's your name?
Trying to build like a...
What's the A&R name?
What's your name?
That's Abby.
Can I hear something?
Fruit bow.
No,
yeah, that's what's up, man. You got a lot of support. A lot of people helping push your whole brand.
It's a lot. It's a whole bunch of us. And the thing is, we're building a hub. So it's not just about me. It's not just about them. It's not just about y'all. It's about all of us. We trying to do in Jersey what they do in Atlanta, what they do here. You know what I mean? But from a whole. Everything from the education down to the connection to the labels, all that shit.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to shoot some pornos, so that shit gotta work. Yeah, okay. I'm dead ass.
Okay, I believe you. Dead ass. You got a studio that they said you built.
Yeah, man. Me and Mike and our partners, yeah.
I get a casting couch.
That's
fine. I definitely helped build this to myself.
That the other green room you got right here kind of look like the casting couch porn room.
That's what I'm saying, bro. That's it. The vision behind it is like in the most legal way possible. One of these days, I want to like
2021.
Yeah, 2021. Yeah.
Any chicks on IG with French tips, reach out to me. Oh, there you go. There you go.
Work, please.
Abby's in the back. I'm trying to get cast.
Tamaj.
What's good with trying to find me?
Doesn't he look like he's in the porn industry, bro? Come on. Look at the cyber. It's a cyber.
The cyber.
Damn, bro.
That's definitely porn star cyber. Got the Ron Jeremy going on.
No, Ron Jeremy selling
get that on camera,
right? Ron Jeremy selling me sex pills that one of my friends from high school actually used. And he said it worked. I'm promoting Ron Jeremy right now. Right. If your man's not y'all mean and your girlfriend not satisfied, go to Pornhub.com/Ron Jeremy and cop them pills.
Yeah.
I think Ron Jeremy's in jail right now, but whatever. You know what I'm saying? We all just move past that. But
Okay. Since Ron Jeremy's in jail, we on this topic, right? Yeah. How y'all feel about R. Kelly?
Oh man!
Do you separate the music from the artist?
I separate the music.
He's still a king of R&B, man. Certain songs I can't listen to the same, but still,
DJ still play it. People be mad or people vibe out. They be mad, but still vibe out. They be fronting.
Let me tell you. I put on my story the other day because my girl was listening to R. Kelly and The Will, and she's like a big R. Kelly supporter. Mm-hmm. So I put on my story. It's like, yo, free R. Kelly, but keep him in jail.
Yeah.
Like, okay. This by like 700-800 people said keep R. Kelly in jail.
Yeah.
I expected that. I did not expect like 500-600 people to say free R. Kelly. And they were all girls.
My motto is he did that shit for free R. Kelly.
Yeah, you know you got the sauce where you can do that shit and everybody still wants you out. Yeah. It's wild. Yeah. Bill Cosby ain't had that look, bro.
Cosby ain't do it. It's all good though. We gonna move past that. We'll talk.
I seen your image. You changing a lot. You've been doing that since 15, the whole dreads and everything.
Yeah, I mean, no, because my mom, God bless her, so she did not fuck with the whole hair shit. But towards like me growing up, I kind of got into it.
Yeah.
And I love, because I was a big fan of Chief Keef. Big fan of Chief Keef. Like, I love Chief Keef. If I ever meet Chief Keef, that's probably one of the few people I'll be like, Yeah, so I used to be in the shower listening to like just drill music with like a washcloth on my head, and that was my dread. So then from then on, I was like, one of these days, I'm getting dreads.
You know how to ask. Yeah. Did 6ix9ine influence the Rainbow one?
Honestly, nah. Like 6ix9ine.
Yeah, Rainbow dreads, in case y'all know what I'm talking about.
So this was way more defined before all this COVID shit. I actually cannot get someone to do my hair for life that I trust. Talented motherfuckers being bougie, got red masks. But 6ix9ine, I'm not gonna lie. I fuck with early 6ix9ine, the way he was coming with shit. But I remember we was at it was like the Movement Space is just like, it was the first day. There's a space in Jersey called the Movement Space. They had just opened and I was there, and this nigga 6ix9ine came in with like 80 niggas.
Yeah.
But he was there for like 5 minutes. But he just came in with 80, like it was like he fucked the whole shit up because it's like Sierra and shit. Came in with 80 niggas. Niggas just like, who's this nigga? Yeah. Then they were like, oh, 6ix9ine. But I got the rainbow colored dreads because I had red and green at the time. And then I was getting pink. And while I was getting pink, the girl was dyeing my hair. I was looking, I was like, yeah, just try blue. And then I was just purple.
Yeah.
I'm colorblind anyway, so I can barely notice the difference. So I was
okay. See, I thought the dread influence might have been from Lil Wayne. Plus, you got a song with Lil Wayne.
Yeah.
You
know,
talking about Tip
Bannister. Tip Bannister.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, I was like.
Yeah. I like Lil Wayne, but I pay attention to Lil Wayne. I'm influenced by Lil Wayne, but I listened to Lil Wayne when I was a kid. So it's like, I'm like subconsciously.
Yeah.
I fuck with Lil Wayne heavy, like super Lil Wayne fan. But like, I wasn't going to Lil Wayne concert.
He wasn't living the life at the time when Lil Wayne was popping.
Yeah, I was in the suburbs, but I couldn't go outside after a certain time.
Yeah, that's that was generation right there. I do want to go into one of these music videos real quick.
Word.
Which one you think we should do? We should go straight to Akon, or what you got?
Yeah, fuck it, going to Akon.
Going to Akon, see what else you got. 100K
views right there. 100,000 and something. And if you don't rewatch it,
116,000 to be exact.
By this week. So we're going to see what's going on next week.
And if you don't rewatch it, you're going to get a hole in your tires.
On that note,
we're
going to go see this battle.
Elections, no. Revolution, yes.
Trying to play me like a kid, but I ain't one. I'm going to build a city like Akon. Burn a white down with napalm. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till that day come. Tryna play me like a kid, but I ain't one.
If you really wanna go, I ain't stopping it. You pretend to be legit, I ain't arguing. I don't like the news, I ain't never watching it. I just need to be masseuse, girl, come and goggle it. You see this? Ain't that picture, you gon' miss her. The booty shake, she turn around and I remix her. Nothing but my mistress, I really shouldn't kiss her. The way this thing goes is we humpin' and we split up. Tryna play me like a kid, but I ain't one. I'ma build a city like Akon. Burn a white down with napalm. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till that day come. Tryna play me like a kid, but I ain't one.
Babies crying, cops trying to shoot my people. Can't believe it, everyone is so evil. Fear no evil, feel no man. I'm that monkey, yeah I am. Sam I am. Out the can, out the pot. We whip that rock, I grip that block. We rip your block, I take your whip. Break yourself, I bust your lip. I flop my wrench, I dig me back.
Tryna play me like a kid, but I ain't one. I'ma build a city like Akon. Burn a white down with napalm. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till the day come. You gon' wait till that day come. Tryna play me like a kid, but I ain't one.
What you say? I don't give a fuck. 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 What you say?
People
downtown at the disco.
Say so. I be going everywhere that she can go. I need the money in the bag for the bingo. Focus on the level of my work, shawty, fuck you. I just wanna make it and do everything I want to. I ain't got the time, I told God to expose you. I ain't gotta try, but I know how much we go through. This right here can change your life. I can't let you break what's mine. If I make this sacrifice, we will never have our time.
From Akon, the video, you know what I'm saying? That was a really interesting video, very abstract, kind of anarchist type of style.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Explain it, man, or even, how do you feel about it, man?
I liked it because it's different. Like, you know, everybody got gang everywhere, and they're not doing no different stuff, so.
Exactly.
So I was looking, I watched it a couple times, like 3-4 times to see what you was doing, like, wilding it.
Yeah, bro, honestly, like, I'm at the time I made that song, I was just looking at a piece of paper, and I'm, what happened? This George Floyd shit happened. Then we going to COVID. I'm just like, damn, there's a lot of shit going on. But niggas been making all these sad songs. Get it. I'm like, man, fuck this. We got to do something about this.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to, I ain't necessarily saying I'm about to go to Capitol Hill.
Yeah.
Going to, you know what I mean? But if I can inspire the feelings.
Yeah.
For why we all doing that, fuck, we lit.
Okay. I respect that you come different when it comes to these videos. Like, the other day you was looking like Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. That shit is gonna be crazy, bro. Yeah, that shit is gonna be crazy.
What's that video for?
It's done. I have this 2-pack coming out on the 29th of January.
That's what you was talking about, yeah? Mm-hmm. January 29th, what's coming out?
January 29th. Then I'm dropping a song on the 5th. Then I'm dropping a video on the 19th of February.
Mm-hmm.
I think every week I'm dropping something.
Ooh,
yeah,
content.
Yeah, okay. I have enough songs to drop a song a week for the next 2 years.
Okay, the next 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Guys,
yeah, nice. I have over 1,000 songs.
Yeah, one called Fat Pussy.
Yeah, that's gonna be one for the kids. That's yo, for the kids, bro.
That's gonna be fire.
All kids under 9 is gonna fuck with that song.
A song that I like from you, Dylan. Cash flow.
Another
very. Very unique video. You had no head on with the little Rush Hour, Kung Fu Gi on type situation, looking like Bruce Leroy or something. I don't know.
What's cool about all my videos is they're all shot like because of how the shit just happened. Every video leading up to this point, each month, my life has progressed in crazy ways. Like I've been in different cribs, like just upgrading. Mm-hmm. Like yo, what's crazy is one of my apartments, I still got a lease in, and I just left that bitch to a new one. And it's just like that video, like here, the video I'm about to put out has footage from this place before it was built. So yeah. Like, it looked crazy, Yeah. Akon got downstairs where we built the podcast area, your bitches set. Mm-hmm. I shot Akon in that room. Yeah. It's down there. After the shit, I take y'all to you. I'm like, damn, this is crazy. Right. Like, so every video right now is like a stage of life for me. So I'll be watching the videos like, damn, that was a couple months ago. It's crazy. You know what I'm saying? But like it.
Do you ever look at your videos and just laugh at yourself?
Nah, you know what's crazy? A lot. Maybe it's something wrong with me because a lot of people say like I be wilding and I just look at it like that's normal.
Yeah.
I think that's my problem. I think if I don't control myself or keep people around me that could like level me out, I'm gonna get in trouble for something. Cause I be just it's like you turn the camera on, you give me attention, I'm gonna wild out.
Yeah.
And I don't see it as wild now. I see it perfectly normal. Yeah.
Nah, see, you got like a whole lot of different flows. You got the rock star thing, but you still spit and all that. Like, yeah. That song you played for us, I was like, that shit was fire.
Yeah, bro.
But what's your main audience? Like, what do they like the most out of you? Is it that rock star crazy?
You know, shit? Some people like this shit where I'm just saying dumb shit.
Mm-hmm.
Some people like it when I'm saying something. But I think, like, the audience that truly connects me, if you truly know who Only John Madness is, you're going to like everything. Because it's all about my perspective of whatever I'm thinking about. Like, my music is a reflection of where my mind is at. That's it.
So mostly sex, then.
Every song I gotta have something to do with sex, because I always want to fuck. And I've been working out lately. I've been doing, like, squats and shit.
I've seen you play fitness.
Yeah, abs. I'm trying to get abs by the time I get to Vegas, bro. I'm getting there. Yeah. But every time I eat at night, I wake up, it's like, the shit go away.
You gotta do it every day.
Yeah.
You can't miss ab day. Ab day gotta be every day.
How do you like that EP on Fuck Rules?
Fuck Rules?
Yeah, how do you like that?
Love that shit.
Yeah, you got to talk about my dick when I'm drunk, all that type of shit.
Straight ABC shit. Fire.
thank you, bro. Everybody, yo, no, bro. Fuck you. General public who said, because a lot of people was like, this is the least, like, kids like it. Yeah. I never met someone like age.
I thought of kids first when I heard
that. Yeah, same thing.
I don't see no adult.
This is definitely for the younger crowd. What you say? We listening to it together. You're like, this is definitely for like.
But you can picture what it's going for.
Yeah. You know, at one time I did an interview with somebody and it was like, yeah, you know, I like all these songs, but I just feel like the ABC song didn't show how lyrically inclined you were. And I feel like there's so much more you give to your fans. I'm like, my nigga, the song is called ABC.
Yo, people always gonna pick out
something. Yeah. Like, what a nigga.
You got nothing else to say, you're gonna pick out. Yeah. I mean, it's easy to pick that out though. I ain't gonna front.
Yeah,
that's pretty funny.
It was fun. It was fun. I didn't write like that ABC song was.
I'm surprised you didn't make a video for that one.
Huh? I did. Yo, if you watch the Fuck Rules video, right? Watch it all the way through. It's Fuck Rules, Trap House, Hold My Dick, ABC, and When I'm Drunk, all in one. It's like 9 minutes. Mm. Shit, crazy.
Yo, when I'm drunk, you like. It's like you was crying a little bit, like screaming crazy. Did you write that shit? Like, how did you write that shit?
Bro.
I'm about to say, you can't write that.
I was drunk. That's what, like, when I'm...
Which video?
When I'm drunk.
No, the song When I'm Drunk?
Nah.
Yeah, I don't even think I knew Rich at the time. Like, that was really early. And what it was is, like, that whole song, because normally when I make music, I do just that. What you heard is my first take on almost every song. And then I'll come up with the words, vibe out. But with that song, I just felt it. I mean, I was just like,
the fact that you put that together, I respect it. Like, I'm not gonna say that's something that I go to. Like, I gotta listen to this right now. Like, I'm not gonna. But when I heard it, I'm like, this shit, if I'm listening to everything, like, how you even come up with shit like this?
Yeah, like, I didn't. It was.
That I was just hoping you didn't write that down. You had to freestyle that.
Yeah, nah. If I wrote that down, then it would be something wrong.
Yeah. That's why you just think about that and you shoot. I think that's a good song still.
Yeah, I thought it was a good song.
Yeah, it's all vibes, bro. Everything about me is vibes and feelings. Like, I'm not, like, I can't come up with no gimmicks. Trust me, I tried. Shit don't work.
I see it very unique. From your IG and all that, and then the music videos. Like, as I said, like, you're, what you said, the most popular introvert. I don't feel like an introvert, man. I feel like you're just a live guy doing you. You know, by yourself, technically, because, you know, you only you. You know what I'm saying?
That's so with it. The big team on deck. Yo, who's Wave Change? Like, I feel like he probably helped you out a lot too as well.
Wave Change is that nigga, bro. Visually, ain't nobody fucking Wave Change. Nobody.
Nah, I see you, body wildin'.
Yeah, Wave Change is crazy. And the thing is, like, the same way I am with music is the same way Wave Change is with videos. So it's just a really good, it's a good team. Like, me and Wave Change just be like doing shit.
Yeah.
But we do it the same, like, the same way I make music is how he makes videos. It's crazy.
So from Clay Rack too?
Nah, Wave Change is from Linden, I believe. I don't know if he wants me to disclose that information.
But he's not from Clay Rack.
Yeah. Blade Change is from Clay Rack. It's I got a crazy ass team. We got Wave Change, got Matrix, he be engineering, making the beats. Yeah. That's all Sloppy Vinyl. Sloppy Vinyl. That's the team. Sloppy Vinyl.
What's for your type of videos, what's his turnaround like for videos?
Keep it 100. Keep it 100. We shot the Akon video in about 8 hours and put it out the next day because we shot it right before the election. We didn't.
He must have been up all night doing that shit.
Yeah, that's what we do. Like, we some procrastinating ass. Shit,
and you said this whole studio was a whole, you know, not particularly what we can room in, but the whole atmosphere is just for creatives, pretty much.
Yeah, like creatives you. Helping creatives. Our goal is to provide the platform to educate and teach artists, producers, whatever you are in the industry. You can do it, how to finance it, how to do everything, you know what I mean?
Say for me, I'm trying to learn to engineer and all that.
Yeah.
And if I come here, what I gotta do?
You wanna learn how to engineer? Come engineer, you can shadow engineer, work it out. Say no more. Makes sense. It's all about educating the next person because honestly, bro, like this music shit, especially out here in Jersey, like New York, I don't know the New York culture, but in Jersey it's really like a vibe, everyone has their team, everyone's like this. Like, everyone's, because there's a whole bunch of people trying to climb to the top, everybody wants to be that person. But here, it's like, you could be that person. I'll be that person. Whoever want to be the person. We just want to get to where we're going and just help everyone out.
You know what I'm saying? I feel you like a team player, but do you feel like you at one of the tops in Jersey?
I'm the hottest nigga in Jersey.
That's what I like to hear. Energy, boy, stop playing, man, boy.
Clay Rack.
Only nigga, Clay Rack. Table. Small town killers.
You know, I can see you working with. I think I seen you around him before. Samad Savage. I like both y'all styles. Got like different flow, but yeah, I'll be killing you.
That's very interesting, Samad. That's very interesting. Yeah. That means we gotta get in the studio.
Yeah. We actually did an interview with him too. He's one of our first interviews.
That's fine. Samad's a dope ass. Yeah. Samad's dope.
Yeah,
he's very genuine, nigga.
Yeah, that's fact. What was your favorite feature out of all your songs? I think you had somebody named, I can't remember. Robbie Newell.
Robbie was fun. That was Castro was lit.
Yeah.
The Wayne shit was lit. Spider-Cuz was fun as hell. I like the Spider-Cuz, but it was fun as hell.
And that didn't come out yet, right?
Nah, not yet. Oh. I gotta go with Spider-Cuz, but that shit was fun as hell, bro. This is Batman, my nigga. Fuck Batman, bro. DCK.
You about to go on his game? About to join his game?
I don't know, my mom said I can't gangbang.
But you Clay Rack?
You know our mascot is fucking, I think it's a slave ship. Like our school mascot is a slave ship.
Wow, that's not
good. It's crazy. It's a Clipper ship, right? You know, it's fucked up. Yeah. Here it is. Our school is in South Jersey, and the craziest thing, right? We have a football team. Our football team is always, like, just there. And, like, the culture in it, is like we're all like our niggas that come from our town always go to other places to play football.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. So my year we went to the Chip, like we was lit. And one thing I learned from being there is that you gotta like finish strong kind of thing.
Yeah.
Back trail. These motherfuckers had us playing as an anchor, right, the whole time. Then when they painted the mascot in the middle of the field, they put a Clipper shit. We was like, what the fuck?
Yo.
It's like this shit the whole time. It's crazy. But it's not, honestly, it's a good time. It's a good time.
So,
not bad.
You the only one from your camp that's from Clay Rack?
Now. Yeah, there used to be some niggas from Clayton, but
shit
happens, man.
Wait, you not from Clay Rack?
I'm from the next town over.
You see where the ops be.
Shut up.
You got sponsored that. I seen you promoting that drink.
That's crack. Yeah, Adrenaline A-Shop Energy. They be sending me cases. Yeah. I be getting cases. Shout out to Josh. Shout out to Rich. Connected that shit. I be getting these cases, and like when I drink them, I drink like 4 or 5 at a time.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm off Adderall, bro. I know. And I've never done Adderall before, so if I had to be on Adderall, that's what it's liquid Adderall. But it's good. It helps me. It helps.
Well, me listening to music, I'm very interested to see how you put together this freestyle.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It's I don't know if I should be scared or it should be like, we going with today?
I said this is going to be our most interesting freestyle. That's what I said there.
Damn.
That's pressure.
Yeah, it's a lot of pressure.
Yeah. But you're the top of Jersey, so you know, Clay Racks, man. It's nothing.
But here's how I put it. Like, ain't nobody else going to freestyle. Like, if I do a terrible job, it's still going to be hard.
damn. Don't let that go over your head.
God, like, bro, I'm telling you, I could just.
His levels, his quality levels up.
I could just do this on the beat. Oh. It's harder than y'all. Nah, it's all love.
You see what you're talking about, though.
It's all love, bro.
Appreciate
all
you coming. Born the Stew.
Yeah, Born the Stew. Sloppy Vinyl. Mm-hmm. Shout out everybody working. You know, everybody in Jersey is the hottest. I am. We all work together. You know what I'm saying? Helping him.
Jersey working with Jersey, you know the vibes.
Jersey support Jersey.
You know what I'm saying?
Straight like that. Let's get to freestyle. I'll bullshit.
It's only Chamez. Who in the Stew? And I've came. I saw. And I motherfucking conquered, nigga. Baby girl got good pussy, good head, bad intentions. She ain't got a scam, I give her all of my riches. Hit it in the kitchen, knocking over the dishes. I know she ain't loyal, but that's cool, I ain't tripping. She bait a nigga back in school, they be kissing. He a fool on the low, she be stripping. Pull up to the spot, stay for 25 minutes. She like, daddy, I want you to get up in this kitten hell. Know my girl home, but maybe next time. You know niggas ain't shit, but I respect mine. Baby, if your nigga broke, tell his ass lie. What they know won't hurt, live your best life. I always be a hoe. Spending all my money on flashy clothes. Hustle every day, hope I don't go broke. A dog is a dog and a hoe is a hoe. Them African bookworms, light-skinned white bitches, Spanish hoes, capricos, shrimp fried rice bitches. Pull up with a few, blow a rack, leave with five bitches. I ain't do relationships, but I did not one night bitches. I got a lot of pride, I couldn't fuck with dyke bitches. Back in the day, I would woo-woo and Skype bitches. Niggas hate me cause I wasn't scared to try bitches. Now with my girl, and all she wanna do is fight bitches. You know, it's only time it's who in the Stew. Fucking your bitch to the beats, on the beat, with the beat. And I'm talking on the beat, cause I'm keep talking on the beat. See, you niggas be running on the beats, but I just be walking on the beat. And I'm talking poetic right now, cause I'm just. Shh, on me.